Let us discuss some more important terms in terrestrial magnetism. These are agonic and isogonic lines on Earth's surface. If we just talk about agonic line, we can state that it is the circle on Earth's surface which passes through geographic as well as magnetic poles of Earth. The circle which contain both geographic and magnetic poles of Earth is termed as the agonic line, or this can also be written as this is a line on Earth's surface at every point of which magnetic declination is zero. Let us visualize it with the help of this picture. Here you can see if this is the Earth and these are the Earth's rotation axis and magnetic axis, which are inclined approximately at 11 degrees. Now in this situation, if we just draw a circle on Earth which is in the plane of intersection of Earth, it is a diametrical plane which contains both the axis of rotation as well as magnetic axis of Earth. Then at every point on the circle on Earth's surface, we can see that the geographic meridian and magnetic meridian are the single plane. So we can see the magnetic declination at every point on Earth's surface located on this circle is zero. Or we can say this is the circle which is passing through geographic as well as magnetic poles of Earth. This circle we term as agonic line on Earth's surface. Similar to this, we can define isogonic lines. It is practically difficult to visualize, but practically we can locate the points on Earth's surface which are forming isogonic lines. Let us first define it. These are lines on Earth's surface joining the points where magnetic declination is same. At different points on Earth's surface, we know that magnetic declination, that is the angle between geographic and magnetic meridian, is different. But all those points on Earth's surface where magnetic declination is same, if these are joined with some lines, then these lines are called isogonic lines. For every declination angle, there will be a separate isogonic line. As it is difficult to visualize on paper, that's why we are not studying through a picture, but the definition itself is sufficient to understand what exactly is the isogonic line.